All right. Hey, guys. Welcome to another train simulator video. Today, we're going to be taking a look at the recently released, it's dubbed the B&O Mtn Sub on the Steam store, which you can pick up right now for sale. This is said to be released by High Iron Simulations, but it's actually quite a few people under that moniker, if you will. I'll go ahead and get those out of the way. Michael Stefan, who did track work, signaling, route building, rolling stock and modifications, liveries, assets. Gary Dolezal, the research, some route building and scenarios, DTM, or Caesar Pac, the SD35, SW7, SW9, SW1200, GP40 modifications, chassis 2-bay, covered hopper, and AAR tanker. Paul Dozal, Gary's brother, the assets, a lot of the buildings and good stuff like that. G-Tracks or Rick Grout assets as well. Wayne Campbell, scenery, texturing, smoke box, Mike Rennie, custom air brake scripts and development, which is pretty interesting. I think he's in on this crew for the first time, so that'll be interesting to check out the new realistic braking scripts and whatnot. And then Repo for SD35 audio. So that in itself is interesting. And of course the GP40-2 revisions and updates and things like that. It comes with 13 scenarios. You get 101 miles of the B&O, that's Baltimore and Ohio, Mountain Subdivision West End. You get 30 miles of the Western Maryland Thomas Sub and B&O Cumberland Terminal, and much more. I could just sit here forever and monologue. I'm gonna try not to do that, so settle in. Go grab you a soda, tea, coffee, beer, blanket, whatever. This is gonna take a while. This thing is massive. So we're first gonna be taking a look at the route, which is what I typically like to do, and then at the very end, all the way in Cumberland, because we're currently in West Virginia right now, we're gonna be taking a look at the rolling stock, and there is numerous. This is a tall order. It's very big. So let's try and get started. Anyway, it's set between 1973 to 1979. Just a tiny bit of history. The Baltimore and Ohio was essentially the USA's first common carrier railroad, which was chartered for public service in the early 1800s. It was taken over by C&O in the 60s, and then it kept going from there. There's quite a few grades, ton of industries. It's a lot. It's a lot. Anyway, let's get started here. Grafton, West Virginia, which is where we're currently at here. This is the Grafton shops and turntable. Now, if we look back this way, that's the Fairmont sub that runs down on that away, and then up north a bit. This is the Grafton River down here. We'll get down a little low here. So we've got the old school poles. The telegraph poles and all that good stuff. The plants are like disappearing into the river. See through. Magical plants. But so far, like over here, this is off to a good start. Might I add. Just with the scenery, the bushes, the weeds, all that good stuff. The tracks and the ballast and the track laying, so far from what I've seen, this is me looking at it for the first time with you if you're watching this video. I did set up some stock down at the other end, but I haven't heard anything. I haven't gone into depth with anything at all. So this is a first for me as well. But again, we got a lot to cover. Just a lot. So the B&O color positioning lighting signals were a part of this route as well. So that's pretty cool. That's unique. Let's see. All right, so this way continues. This is still part of the mountain sub, west end, west side, if you will. That continues down on that way. Kind of goes south, southwest, if you will. Look at the town here. I like the little American flags hanging. What is this from? Is this new? This little fill station right here? I don't recall seeing that before. Anyway, that continues down on that away. Got a football field. America. Baseball. Stickball, if you will. Now, one of the cool things about this is a lot of the guys that worked on it have their own library of assets, if you will. And that's what you're going to see. The time period it's set is you're going to see the older vehicles, cars, buses, trucks, stuff like that. Hence this puppy right here. I mean, she's old, but she's still chugging. Look at her go. Got a nice little church. It looks pretty good. I'm gonna be honest. This seems a bit daunting. This map, this route is massive. And the rolling stock is almost into triple digits. It's insane. It's a nice sign. Railroad property. No trespassing. Like the bridge, it's got the fungus and algae and stuff all down at the bottom. Looks very nice. Grafton River flowing. Old bridge right here. That's pretty cool. Now disused. It's even got the embankment there. So, yes, part of it is missing. Interestingly enough. But, you know, it's cool. I love stuff like this. You know, it's not looked over. So, it's there. Some more old bits over here. I forget what they call this. They call this like the bank track or something like this over here. Anyway, here's the roundhouse and the shops. This place is massive as well. We'll scooch up over here. It's nice that it's, you know, it's got plants and whatnot just kind of scattered about. You know, I'm all for a bit of, like, just junk and clutter and stuff like that laying around. There's a little bit up there, but typically, yes, some might say, oh, well, they would keep it clean because it's a safety hazard. That may be very prototypical and real life and stuff like that, but in something like this, the more the merrier, the more alive and used it feels, if you know what I mean. Got this bridge over here. It's a nice footbridge. That's not so nice. The filled in, you know, earth that could have been over here. Yeah. Old school whistle post. Very nice. So there may be things like that. I mean, this is the end of the line. This is the extreme western end of the route. The other end is Cumberland in Maryland. So we're going to head that way. Let's take a better look at the shops here. Got a nice turntable. Big shops, too. This would probably look pretty darn sweet with a bunch of engines poking out of there. Especially the steam era. Oh, that'd be cool. Town of Grafton up on the banks, looking over the river. Typical little West Virginian town, if you will. Little quaint town tucked away. Kind of stuck in time. Good looking tower. Grafton D Tower, right on. So it's labeled. Little, like, extra bits all around it. Like this little fence post or pipe or whatever that is. And this thing down here and this barrel for fuel, probably a heater inside there, something like that. Then the old window unit sticking out. Spotlight. Of course, these would be, you know, derelict, torn down, disused by today's standards. But That's one of the things I'm noticing is there's no staircase, so possibly there'd be a staircase inside. But it's labeled. That's pretty cool. Man, these shops are massive. Massive. Alright, so over here, of course, we got fuel tanks, sand, petrochemicals, things like that. We got some garbage and trash and stuff laying around. Another thing you'll notice is a lot of these assets, rolling stock included, are fairly aged. To try and put as gently as possible. You'll notice that with some other things as well. But there are some custom assets that were placed on this route that a lot of the guys, I'm sure, painstakingly made. That's nice. Got a staircase going all the way up yonder. Alright, so this is kind of like downtown Grafton right here. It kind of actually looks the same today to a degree from what it used to look like. And what's kind of cool about the place is it was a big deal during the Civil War because it was a strategic target, being that the railroad, you know, B&O, oldest railroad in America, this was a part of that. So it was strategic for operations and stopping the movement of troops and goods and things like that. So it's an old place, and if it's, you know, got some history, I'm all aboard. Anyway, this is the historic station right here, complete with an old baggage cart, telephone booth, the steps leading down. REA. Rail Express Agency. Got some benches. It looks pretty nice, like the track laying over here and the platforms. I like these signals too. They look pretty good. And they also look like they almost seem faded to a degree, like the coloring of them, but you can see them. Now if you can see them from a great distance, I don't know. They seem to still allow you to see, you know, their indication. Ooh, that's a nice sign. There's just so much going on here. Seriously, it's overwhelming. Just completely honest. Bit overwhelming. Anyway, the Tigert Valley River and Three Fork Creek all kind of meet over here as well. But the old B&O Historic Railway Station is over here. It's built in like 1911, I think. And then this right here is the Grafton Hotel. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I think both of these are nationally registered on the National Association of Historic Things. So, yeah, it's cool having these two buildings here. And the town looks pretty good, you know. I always enjoy the little town scene like this, you know, especially if it looks alive and it's dotted with just things out of the way that you probably wouldn't otherwise see. I mean, these houses right here are floating. You could easily probably go on the world editor and slap those down in the earth. We'll go up discreet here. See, most people probably don't care about stuff like this. I do, on the other hand. Call me weird. I mean, yeah, this has nothing to do with the railroad operation down below. You're not going to be seeing this stuff, but I don't know. I find it interesting. A bit of a floater again. Floaty float. I think the road's floating. Yippers. But it looks all right. And just then, when I swung the camera around and saw down in the river valley, that's gorgeous. Beautiful, beautiful country here and in real life. I mean, I can tell just by looking at the terrain and mountains way the trees were placed and things like that, it looks good. Looks good. All right, it's been what, like an hour, and we're not even out of Grafton yet. So it feels like, anyway. The only kind of glaring thing that I guess gets to me about this area, and you know, to each their own. The riverbank, yeah, they're a bit steep, IRL. But just, I don't know, that whole look without, you know, having rocks or grass or something, then it's just that bare ground texture. That never looks good to me. But again, you're not going to see that on the railroad, you know. But I find stuff like that a bit irkious. It's more of the downtown. The town looks pretty good, though. Got speed limit signs over there. Cars everywhere, all kinds of different trees. It's a good-looking little town. West Virginia. Nice bridge, too, of course. Huge! Alright, let's start our slow trek eastbound and down. Well, actually, it's more eastbound and up, and then up some more. Not down at all. Anyway, this map is so damn big that zoomed out all the way, you still got to scroll. It is massive. So anyway, I'm gonna try and cover as much as I possibly can. So this is the west yard for Grafton, and then the aptly named east yard is just around the corner there. Got some old rails laying here. Little shack. Complete with lights. No telling what it looks like at night. I'd like to take a peek, though. For sure. Procedural grass. I swear I turn that off and it still pops up. I'm not a big fan of procedural grass. I don't know if it's like built into roots or whatnot and you can't do squat about it. There we go. Love that old school look at that house right there. It's nice. Front porch right on the railroad too. Foamers would pay top dollar to live there. The river looks a little bit better down here. I like this compared to the higher banked bit up in downtown Grafton. It looks nicer. It's a bit flatter. I know that working at an angle with terrain and train sim isn't the easiest thing to do, and it can just leave stuff looking like that. But I'm just calling it like I see it, you know. Just my personal view and opinion. These yards are massive. There's a lot of stuff you can do back here. Some more barrels and ties and shiz laying around, which is nice. Another footbridge, like these old iron footbridges. Very nice. All right, this is still West Yard or is this East Yard? I think it's East Yard. Huge. Absolutely massive. The signals look all right. I mean, they're pretty crispy. Even the plate down at the bottom, those are all right. Very nice. All right, gonna try and keep this moving. That right there. Oi, oi. Oy vey, this is what I'm talking about. Like, that's just gnarly, you know. Not to be mean or negative, that just does not look good. I don't know what can be done about that, but it just, you know, that right there, and then you got this little beep poking out right here. It's maybe it's like one of those monolith things like they found in Utah. Back in the 70s. Anyway, back to the yard. Ooh, there's some more. It's just got that muddy look from afar, the textures. And it's the whole, wow, the whole ridge line up there's got it. Goodness gracious. Goodness gracious. All right, zooming on out of here. Let's check these foundations. Looking aight. This looks pretty good. Riverbed, creek bed, creek. Ah, and then we got the old stone arch bridge as well. Very nice. Or brick. Stone? No. Brick. Ah, okay. There we go. Gantry. Tower time. That looks pretty good. Me likey. That's all right. The fact that it's floating, not so much. But, yeah, other than that, it's a good looking signal bridge. Hot dang. It's not too clean. It's weathered, rusted. Just keep on trucking. Another tower. What's this here? Danger. Stranger danger. Authorized personnel only. What is that? Get train orders out of there or dumped in there? Something like that. Another heat and tank for the outside of the sucker. This one's got a staircase. I'm not sure what this is. This is interesting. It looks like a couple of rails put together under like a bit of a cover here. So maybe something slid in and out of there. Kind of sign without a sign on it. It's pretty interesting though. Getting back on our high-speed bullet train. There's the river on this side. Now this is interesting. The land over here is lower than the river. Looks like it have some overflow issues, maybe. Not sure if it's like that in real life or not. I think there's a highway up over here. Yeah, there it is. I just want to sing some John Denver right now. Yeah, it looks all right for the most part. Just keep on trucking till we find something to look at. Oop. Branches all in your face. A little bald spot or knob. That's what they call bald mountains down where I'm from. That looks a little better. But again, it's not a very sharp angle, you know. So it's got that benefit. You know, it's got that going for it. Got some birds tweeting. The big old rock outcrops. What's going on up here? Digging it out. Is this like some sort of open face mine operation or something? Possibly. The road leads to it back yonder. Like little things like this. I do. It just, it adds to it, you know. It's like extra toppings on your pizza. Keep on trucking. A little rock outcrop there. That looks all right. Jeez, I'm thinking to myself, nice sign, slow. Very cool. I'm thinking to myself right now, like, what a entire traversal of this would take time wise like probably longer than an opera, maybe as long as like a football game complete with commercials. Nice looking post as well, a number board on there. That one's on the ground. Yeah, I'm digging the signaling. It's new to Train Simulator and the likes of what we got here, so that's pretty cool. New is nice when it's done well, anyway. Another sign, faulty. Green. Now, this is definitely unique to the area, B&O, C&O. Keep on going. These signs are everywhere. Very nice. Got some little homes on the river over here. Some farming. Some more rock outcrops. This right here, man. Oh. I'm trying not to dwell. But, yeah, just cover that up with something. You know, grass. I don't know. Something. Put some trees in front of it. Somebody's driving Miss Daisy. They going to town. She's going to get her hair did. Not in a hurry either. Nice looking bridge. Seems to be intact on the ground. Hold up. Wait a moment. So it looks like the telegraph and telephone poles just kind of stop right there. That's interesting. Just making sure that they didn't scooch on the other side of the river here. No? Okay, well. Not the end of the world. All right, I'll try and be serious. Wowie. Some of the foundations on buildings and stuff, they don't seem quite right in a lot of places. But again, you know, it's not earth-shatteringly wrong. But here we are again. It's just like it was gone through in like a speed run with a gallon of sweet tea and a box of Whoppers just plopping buildings down at record pace. Anyway, oh, nice. Link of 13 great states with the nation. That's cool. I like that. Nice little shack. Very nice. Another one of these boxes. That's got to be what that is, right? Train orders. Possibly a station because it's got this planking right here. That's pretty cool, though. I love stuff like that. I like it a lot. Whoop. What was that? Okay. Thought it was a signal or something. Keep on going. Still got some signalage. Those are in the ground. Now I can't stop looking at the telegraph. Making sure it continues. There's a creek back here. So it must be where it just gets so low. You know, that it's not enough to put, like, the actual water in from the editor. More of a texture or whatnot. Got to cross bucks in the stop sign. Man, move. Life moves a little bit slower around here. This looks pretty clean, though, this crossing right here with the rails. That's all right. That's clean. Got a highway up there on the right. Oi. Oi. Again with this. Like, this would probably be fine, you know, for, like, 2009, maybe. But, I don't know. Stuff like that just gets to me, personally. Opinions are like beeholes. Everybody's got one, and that's mine. Sorry. Got a milepost. It's kind of cool. I'm digging the creek. I'm getting some real heavy Penn steam feels, though, with that scenery like that, and the water and stuff. And you'll see as well with a lot of the rail cars and stuff. Once we get to it, if you're not into it for the route at all and you've made it this far, I would recommend skipping to the end of the video because that's where all the rolling stock is going to be. So, otherwise, we will get there at some point, eventually. Carrying on. Those are stuck in the ground. Very nice. Ooh, a crossing. All right. Da-da-doosh. Wow, that ain't that a view right there, though. Like, sometimes you just catch an angle, a spot, and train sim, you know? And that right there is pretty. All right, let's keep on going. We got things to see and people to do. I do appreciate the foliage on the right of way here. It's nice. Because that's one of the big things as well with me is, you know, when a lot of routes just have this extremely bare surface on either side of the railroad. So this, you know, this looks like it was done. It's obviously done by hand, but it was, you know, it was done well and took time doing it to it. I got this weird floating rock. I'm sure this is something... I'm sure this is something in real life. It's probably some state park or something, and you know, people go up here and stand around and look at stuff, or something like that, maybe. But it's not really fastened to the rest of the planet. Now this looks good, the rocks, but again, this up here. I know, I'm trying not to talk about it, but once I see it, I can't unsee it. Nice little burge. Keep off the burge. Right on. Looking good. Foundation looks all right. Deep in the hollers of West Virginia. Oh, another tower. So, number three. It's got this thing again. What is that? I can't believe I don't know what that is. Interesting. Nice looking towers, though. Very nice. Nice. Got another shack. Shack attack over here. Some cable reels. Oh, this one's got the door open. Look at that. That's cool. I like that. I don't know if that was done on purpose. But old disused shack, and there's weeds and stuff growing out of the stove in here. That's pretty cool. See it right through the door there? That's all right. That's nice. All right, let's see. It's hard to tell where I'm at because I'm kind of free roaming right here. So let's see. Sha-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. Where is... Nah, we haven't passed that, right? There's no way we passed that. Big old mine up there. Oh, snap. Was that the bridge? Nah. Hold up. Bridge was this way. Was it? Oh, I'm lost. Oh, my dear God. I'm lost. No, here's a bridge. Okay. Cool, cool, cool. All right, let's see. Go on around the bend. Now the sign, I like these signs. And again, I'm liking the attention to the stuff that's not floating. The scenery and the bushes and plants and weeds and flowers and all kinds of stuff on the side, but this here, man, there's some procedural popping in there, but you know. All right, got another one. Got a floater again. Well, on half of it, seems like. Yep, that one is also high in fiber. High fiber diet. That looks all right. Another sign. 3025, of course, freight and passenger speeds. Ooh, hello. Ah, very cool. That's the that's what they call the Capital logo there, I believe. Capitol. Railroad crossing. Cross box. These crossings look pretty clean, though. Those are nice. And look at that. Banked. Or elevation of the super variety, if you will. Very nice. I'm liking these crossings. I love this era. Like, I'm a sucker for this era. Got some more floaty floats. We're cruising. All right, we're getting up to something. There's a reason all these tracks are popping up here. Oh, hold up. Is this Tunnelton? Let's see. All right, Austin Mine. We ain't been there yet. Did I pass that? There's no way. Did I pass that? There's a Newburgh. I mean, this map is just so damn huge. This is the only time it's widened out here. Okay, so those are the platforms we passed. So there's triple track, quadruples. That's Newburgh. Okay, I saw that church. I thought it was Tunnelton. Newburgh platform. That's Big Ben there. Brains curve, big brains. Cassidy curve. All right, so we should be coming up to that the Y with the coal mine. Austin. All right, so Newburgh, one of the towns along the way, and that's pretty cool, man. I like that that wall right there, that embankment going along the river. Hear the nice gentle flow of the water. They're moving really slow. Super slow. Got a little church over here. Very nice. Complete with the signs again. Very nice. Oh, yes. Yeah. Little old Main Street. Very nice. Even on the ground there. Railroad crossing. It's another one of those shots, you know. You just stop and look and bam, you got a nice view. Alrighty. Here's a station. I believe. Ain't much on it, but... All right, let's scooch. Some of this stuff is a bit messy. Right away there in the gravel. Jagged. All right, those are placed all right. The big old bridge. That is some things though, man. Like, just looking down that way. That's nice. I mean, I'm a southerner at heart, and you know, being pretty much all over the southeast and up to the mid southeast. This is what stuff looks like even to this day, you know. It's kind of frozen in time, and it's got that feel to me. It's got that look for the most part. And it's nice. It's nostalgic almost, even though I was born in the 80s. But keep off the bridge. Nice looking bridge. But it's just got that feel. I don't know. It feels familiar or something. All right. Sloop on up here. So here's Big Brain Curve. This is kind of cool. This bit cuts through these mountaintops here. So we should... Ooh, hello. That's cool. Those are nice. That one looks planted pretty good. Good footing. All right, we are coming up to the mine up here, right? Gotta be. Nice little twisty mountain road. Cross bucks, ties. Getting ready to go down. There's another one. All right. It's like we're getting up out of the valley, the river valley down there. Nice. Complete with the signs again. Good looking bridge. I like that stone. That's all right. That's all right. Another station stop. Alrighty. Alright, here it is. Austin mine. Austin with an E. Not an I. There it is, just ripping the earth up. Got a bunch of crud everywhere. Nice. Offices. Skadoosh right to the end. Alright, well, it looks like a mine. I like that this ridgeline bit, asset, whatever that is, was added there. Gives it a bit of contrast instead of just the side of the hill or mound. All right, so there's one thingamaboo, thingamabob, thingamado. I'll figure out what I'm trying to say here in a minute. Industry. We'll just say industry. All right, so we know where we're at. So that's where we're at. God. Jesus H, man. This is it. Okay, this might be like a two-parter. All right, so we got West End Spur and Platform coming up. All right, Kingwood. Kingwood and Tunnel Tone. So this, some of you may remember the older route, the B&O, Kingwood and Tunnelton. What the heck was it called on the Steam Store? Anyway, it was a route kind of semi-fictional, but... real towns, nonetheless, and those are in here as well. Nice signal mast again. A little spur there. Yeah, those crossings are clean again, man. That's just like... That looks good. That looks good. Bit of the town over here. Run back over here. Another old rundown shack with the weeds of the raccoons living in there. Ah, here we go. What's this, tower number 4? And this one does not have the thingamabob down there. And we got a tunnel. Whistle posts. Now, sadly, I cannot fly in there. Free camera Lee. So I'll have to fly over it. That's cool. It's a good looking tunnel. That's all right. You can see the old one over here as well. Old derelict tunnel and the line that went through there. You know, again, with some of the terrain, it's just, it's big with me. That's why I keep noting it. If it's not with you, that's fine. But like this right here, you know, if this could have been smoothed out or covered up with something, just so it's not so blunt. Oh, wait, no. I thought it was going to let me go in there for a minute. All right, so we got to find where the HE double hockey sticks this goes. There it is. Here's the upper one here. That's cool, man. Two tunnels kind of staggered like that. But again, the terrain, man. You can see through it right there. That's not in that. Like, come on. It's so sharp. Anyway. Now, this is nice. The fact that this up here isn't just covered with grass texture. You know, it's the old rail bed, and you can tell something was there. All right, let's see. So that's the Kingwood Tunnel. All right, Tunnelton eastbound, drill track, hill track, mud track. So this is Tunnelton here. Let's see, Tunnelton, West Virginia. Was it West Virginia North? Blazer. All right, let's keep scooching. Another nice little footbridge. Good looking little town. I mean, in the old Kingwood to Tunnelton route, you know, it showed its age, but it was still one of those routes where, you know, at the time, everything on it was new and pretty much fresh for that route specifically. And it's, you know, it's same towns, same general vicinity, but just updated, you know, looks better. Better foliage, nicer tracks, newer buildings and assets, stuff like that. Of course, new ba-bam. Those are pretty nice. I like those. This right here could have been, you know, touched up. Just saying. For what it's worth. There's a church. There's the station. Very nice. Good looking station. Man, that's another thing. Like, none of the scenarios, as far as I know, are passenger turns. But you could certainly do something. Another box. You could certainly do something, man, blasting through here with an old kettle. That'd be pretty damn cool, though. Kind of a floating truck. All right. Cold country out here, though. Cold, cold, cold. It's nice. Good looking building. Got that high embankment there. Keeping it from slipping over. All right. Was that the WVN? Yeah, that's got to be that, right? Yeah. Okay. Another mine. Sounds of things happening. Industrials. Got some logging going on. We're going. Another station. Good night. These things are everywhere. Didn't realize how many there were out here. Another bridge. Crossing back over the creek. Nice. Wowee. It's another one of those times. This is it. Just hit me. Goodness gracious. That's pretty. Boy, oh boy. Ah, that's right. I think there's a dam up here. I believe. Reservoir. Now this right here looks all right. You know, you're coming along here and you got this big old just open granite face here, or whatever that is, probably granite. Curving around here, man, this is high up over here. Let's not get too ahead of ourselves, find out where the heck we're at here. What was that? We just passed, what was that, Blazer? Blazer? Clements Fountain Flower Garden number 2. What the hell kind of name is that? So there's the other track down on the other side. Let's see what this portal is here. Kingwood Sub. Yeah, so that was part of the older other route I was talking about. And that's where it ends. Don't think much activity is going to happen over here. Keep on cruising. We should come together up here somewheres. So, there we go. Just my potato personal computer. Taking its sweet time. Look at that. Good God. All right. Now we're talking. Industrious. Set up nicely with the equipment and trucks. Buildings look like they're on the ground for the most part, where they should be. Little twisty ass road up to the top. They are cutting that mountain down. That's pretty neat. That's pretty neat. Alright. Make sure I didn't pass anything over here. Oh, hello. Hello. Yes. That's nice. 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 That's a fine looking specimen of a bridge right there. Okay. We got many more miles to go. Trying to keep it on track here. All right, let's see. 76 fill number 2 main. So it didn't even say what all that was back there. That mine. Yep. Another town, couple of baseball fields. Gas station. Wait a minute, am I on the right? Am I on the dang track up there? I am. Idiot. Oh, wait, no. Yeah, it is. It's double lined all the way down, I think. So, hold up. Okay, there it is. Jeez Louise. Alright. So, this is where we are. It's Ralsburg. Let's see. Let's see what we got here. Tipple. Alright, some coal action. It's like a little old station right here or something. And shkublimity blam, it's floating. Alright, this seems to be a theme. It kind of shocks me that, you know, I know people test this stuff and it gets looked at. It just kind of shocks me that, you know, it's one thing to have a couple of those, but then when it just starts happening in great numbers, it's, you know, it's hard not to pick of the nit variety. Ralsberg, I like the station, nice old house there. Very nice. Steel beam bridge. That is gorgeous. Goodness. Got the other track over here. Crossing. So they should come together right up here. What do we got over here? Like old mom and pop gas station. Back when they'd come out and do it for ye. Nice bridge. Alright, where's that tipple at? Oh, the tower? Coolio? I didn't realize Ralsberg was this big. I don't know if it still is, but that's a pretty sizable yard there. Ooh, hello, bridge. God dang. Love me some bridges. Purdy. All right. Hey. Axle and wheel shop. Right on. Right on. Here's a tipple. Very old. Disused, it would appear. Alright, so keep on trucking out of Ralsberg. Another bridge. Signal gantry. There's a crossover. Ain't seen many of those yet. Oh, hello. That is nice. That's nice. It's got that look. It's getting me in the mood to go back up to the mountains. It's got that look and that feel. And from where I live, down in the extreme southeast, when you say the mountains, you know, that basically means Appalachia. Smokies. Even though this is technically Alleghenies. Still part of the Appalachian chain for the most part. Alright, we gotta figure out where we're at on the map here. So that was Ralsberg. What's the next big dealio here? Alright, so we got a couple of big old curves. Graveyard curve. Yeah. Must be one of them places you better WYA. Keep on going. Another crossing. Nice. Another little station house up here. Anybody home? So, you know, it is apparent that, and it was no secret to begin with, that a lot of this stuff is old assets. But that's not always, it's not always necessarily a bad thing, you know. Or a black eye, if you will. It's, you know, the stuff is old, yes, but they were cool assets to begin with, in my eyes. But you know, a lot of time obviously went in to laying this. I mean, this friggin' place is massive. Here it is, graveyard curve. Here's the graveyard. That's cool. The only thing that gave it away was the flowers there. That is interesting. I bet you there's a story behind that, and I have nary a clue what it is. I'm going to guess something train related. This is pretty nice right here. Grab you a picky of a eastbound. Chugging around that curve right there. That's nice. But yeah, anyway, it's, you know, I'm sure this, I can't even fathom how long and arduous this would take to build a route on this scale, no less. But it's obviously got a lot of man hours. It's got a lot of recycled stuff. It's got a lot of good stuff, even though some of it's recycled. You know, from some of the better North American routes over the years, some of the really classic, you know, even though it's kind of over the hill, you know, if you want to put it like that, it's still, you know, I love it to this very day. But, you know, it'd be nice to have some new stuff at some point, you know. I can't be the only one. Getting a little bit more hilly, less mountainous. But I would like to add this, you know, I am not overlooking this just because I'm not mentioning it 100 times. The grass trackside, paramount. This is absolutely paramount to me. And I just feel like it makes, you know, line side stuff just look so much more legit. And it's all throughout from what I've seen so far. Nice crossing. Got a barn down yonder. Some more masts. Keep on trucking. Whoop. Oh, God. Did I just turn around? All right. Yeah, we're going this way. Wait a minute. Total deja vu. Oh, wait, no. Good God, look at that view, man. And that's what, you know, when all these guys came together under the High Iron Simulations moniker, you know, it's a handful of devs that have been around for quite a while in the TS scene, North American stuff and otherwise, and, you know, they all added to this in their own way. In different ways, and you can see it shining through in some places, and you can see it in the sheer fact that the Hanover sub, you know, was built by them all as well, and this is the same gang, if you will, same posse. Nice little ditch pipe there. Looks good. All right. Let's see. Where was it's graveyard curve. I'm going to have to look that up. If you know about it, let me know in the comments if you know what that's all about. Or you have any questions or anything at all, as always. Feel free. All right, Terra Alta. Let's see. There's nothing on that. I wonder if it's just a Y. It looks like it's just turn around. Good looking little town though. It's got a different look to it, you know. It's a little bit gentler rolling hills out here. Good God, look at that downtown street. Could use maybe like some lampposts or something like that, but that's cool. That's nice. Good looking little town though. I declare. Very nice. Another tower. Is that like tower number 7, I think? Another station. All right, here's the Y. Why? I don't know. You just turn engines around, essentially. If they're not going any farther westbound. Another culvert, ditch, pipe going under the road there. Another crossing. Now it's coming through a little bit. It is super elevated, obviously, which is, you know, it's going to be nice. Track laying's big deal. The train system, right? But it's not terrible. That's like the only issue I've seen on these level crossings so far. Just keep on going. Ooh, what they got over here? The beans, soybeans, tobacco, something. I don't know. What do they grow out here? I got something going in there. Jeez. Another crossing. Nice. Still following a creek over there. Oh, here we go. Now that's cool. Big old embankment running right through this valley here. I wonder if this is like a flood zone or something. There's a creek over there. It's got to be, right? I mean, why else would it be built like that? Get it up out of the flood zone. That's cool as hell, though. A nice bridge. Some more tight curves. Very tight. Another town. Alright, I don't want to get lost on the map here. So that was Terra Alta. That was Hopemont Platform. Where's those twisty arch turns at? Is that it right there? Alright, we didn't see these little spurs here at Oakland, so we haven't got up there yet. Another shack attack. There's another. Dude, what's cool about this is like a lot of this stuff would have been torn down or withered away with time and weather and stuff like that. And the area it's set, you know, B&O, C&O, chassis, whatever. You could easily do early CSX up here. Some gray ghostage. Easily. Maybe some YN2. Maybe go a bit older as well, steam-wise, if we had the equipment. Yay! Big old river getting a little bit deeper there. You can tell it's getting a little bit flatter out here. Another bridge. Alright, that's nice. Alright, they actually got that built onto the bridge, so that wasn't overlooked like that one bridge down by Grafton. Very good. Nice little town. Got some kind of treatment plant over here. Alright, those little spurs should be coming up. There they are. Okay. So, Oakland, let's see. That's a team track there. Got the platform up there. What's this right here? Lumber spur. So, there's you some industry. Oak Town. Sure no one here calls it that. Good luck in station. It's a nice looking asset. Oh, hello. That's it, man. Like, that's it. That's a little, you know, southern eastern mountain town. You can kind of see it poking out of the tops of the trees. That looks amazing. That looks really nice. Got a bit of a railing there. Oh, hello, four-way. Very cool. I don't know where that goes. Nice town. This is probably, well, when you look that way, maybe not so much, but back, you know, back down on the track is, it's a cool looking town. Probably one of the most scenic so far. Bridges everywhere. There's a lumber yard. Oakland Oak. Get it? Yeah, that's a bad joke. So there's you some more industry. So it ain't just bridge and cross traffic. Keep on scooching down. Got another bridge there. Very nice. Let's see what we got here. All right, that was... Let's see, it's Mountain Lake. Yeah, it's got to be Mountain Lake. Okay. Mountain Lackey. Another tower? Oh, there's the Hardee's. I'm getting hungry. Go get me a Frisco melt. Good looking town here too, man. I gotta say, like, if it was purely designed to be seen at this level, which, to be honest, a lot of train sim stuff is, this looks phenomenal right here. There's not a train in sight, but this looks damn good right here. And there's a lot of places on this route that give me that funny feeling. What's this here? Mountain Lake Park Building Supplies and Mountain Lake Park Electrics. Two more industries. There you go. Bing bang. Wait, is that the electrics? They even got a dock, loading dock right on. Good deal. It's definitely a lot flatter. Another crossing. Very nice. Not sure what that is. Another crossing. If you're a horn nut like me, good to go. Whistle boards, bridges, towns, more bridges. Yeah, it's pretty gentle rolling hills out here. Hidden in the Maryland. In fact, we might already... Are we already in Maryland? Let's see, where the heck... There it was. Okay, let's see. Rich on 47 cut. Bottling house curve. Altamont. Okay. Here it begins. So something like a, I think, 17-mile grade between the summit at Altamont and Piedmont. And I believe that's what we're coming up to here. Nice little farm. Looks like I got some apple trees or something over there. Very quaint and cozy. Another tower. Man, it's a shame stuff like that ain't around anymore. Ah, here we go. Here we go. Summit of the Alleghenies, altitude 2,628 feet seas. Now the bridge, let's see what this, some kind of rip right here. Doesn't say what it is, Altamont platform though. So you can't see it because I don't have a HUD, but you're going to be, chugging. If you're just taking in the scenery, you're going to either have to keep the hand on the throttle with the sand button or dynamics and air. Because it is a pretty steady gradient out here. Several of them, too, not just this one. It's like 4 or 5 summits, something like that. Ooh, nice little back country road dirt track. That's cool. That is cool. I love stuff like that. Keep on going. I think we're about halfway, maybe. We're lucky. Like this service road right along the tracks here. Another house. Come on. Like we're getting back down in it now. Back in the mountains instead of on top of them. This looks good through here. That's what I'm talking about, man. Like the that stuff back towards Grafton, like some of the hillside bits and whatnot. This almost looks like it was done by a different person or something. This is nice. Yes. Nice. Oh, what? Oh, is that a runaway? Runaway. Strecker. Yeah. Nice. I mean, you don't want to be going up this thing, but it's cool that it's there. Ooh, look at that valley. That's pretty. Another tunnel? Yeah, see, even this tunnel, okay? Back towards Grafton. Remember the tunnel if you're still here. Remember that bit? This looks way better. Nice. Yes, this is nice. This is like, I'm starting to get the feels from Hanover Sub in here, you know, scenery-wise and how decent it looks. This is nice. This map is massive. I feel like I need a snack. And I'm going like 200 mile an hour. There it is. There's that reservoir. I knew there was one out here. Ouch. All right, let's see. What's the next? It's Bond. Bond Runaway. He's a little runaway. Nice. Keeping them towns and houses in the valley below nice and dry. Nice. Another little tur. There's your runaway track. And back down, steady down too. This will be really interesting to try out old Mike Rennie, aka Smokebox's new brake scripting. Yep. All right. What is this cozy little townage? Big curve, Everett's curve. All right, so Hampshire, you got a coal tipple down in there. That's westbound to Elkins. Let's see. Bloomington platforms. There's another train station. Barrelwood Yard. Big Junction. We're not even anywhere close. Good golly, Miss Molly. All right. Graveyard over here on the hill. That's nice. It's an interesting town. The way it's built and laid out here. Nice bridge. So let's see, that is it's Barrelwood Yard. Okay, let's run up this right here, the Hampshire line. I believe that's it right here. I mean, it's still decorated, still got poles. Telegraph, telephone, poles, another bridge. Here's your tipple. It's a good looking tipple too. Looks better than the Austin one, that's for sure. Got some ambient sounds. And then it keeps on going up that way. You can't go that way too far. Go back up to the main. Damn, and lumber it is. Jeez Louise. I got mega wood. Alright, so that is definitely an industry. And it looks like somebody's exhaust pipe made it into train sim. Things are huge. Huge. Yeah, this is cool through here. That's alright. Oh, I love that. The old, like, foundation look in the ground. I love that. That looks nice. Good God, this place is massive. Western Maryland Central Junction. Okay, so let's see, that was the yard. It's a friggin' bowl of spaghetti right here, man. Alright, Kelly's Curve, Piedmont Paper Mill. Paper Mill, Paper Mill. Of course there's a paper mill right by the damn lumber yard. Let's see. Alright. Another box. Dude, this is pretty cool. We've got a dam right here. This is excellent. Muy, muy excelente. That looks like a paper mill. That looks like a paper mill. And if I would take a stab at where you're going to use a switcher, this is going to be it right here. Show. Places like this, the whole town would be employed at for the most part. Whole county, for that matter. That's nice. Get some more algae. I don't know how I got up on that one, but so much stuff. Just stuff everywhere. All right, I don't want to get lost here. Right, this is Piedmont. Let's just go right, y'all. Western Port CMP Branch. So this is the, this has got to be the old Western Maryland bit. It's right across from the other line, right? Kaiser. All right, getting ahead of ourselves. All right. Ooh, look at the old ripped up track running down the street. Cool. Very cool. All right, we're trucking. Another crossing. All right, so there's that line, and there's that line. Both sides of the river. Try and cover them both. What do we got here? Rolling storage, Moreland curve. Excuse me. And it's hard to cover both. Another tower. Huge yard. Super huge. All right, Patterson Creek cut off. McKenzie. All right, so that is Brady Cellulose Plant. Something to do with paper, wood products. All right. Knob Mount. Knobby Knob Mount. Maryland Junction, Elkins. Good God, this map is just so much stuff. Freaking A. Some more shops. Big old round house. Check the other side of the river. There's your knob. Essentially a bald mountain. Taking some stuff out of that mountainside. All right, Jesus, this is so huge. Ay vey. Wait a minute. We're not up there. What the hell? this is Kaiser. Yeah, because there's these two cutoffs. Cooling products. So two more industries. I was thinking we were all the way up at Cumberland already. I was like, no. Let's double check. A lot flatter. Nice bridge once again. A little bit of white water. Another bridge. Oh, that is... Little bridge on bridge action. Very spicy. There it is. Comes back over this way. Joins back on. Alright, let us see. Alright, so here's where it crossed. Came back together. Let's see. There we go. Okay, that's rolling storage. Okay. I thought that was, way up here. I was way off. Another good-looking birch. They're so far apart now, it's hard to cover. Hard to cover both. Another bridge and back together. Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised at this point, seeing what I've seen so far, that, you know, separate people built different parts of this route. It, some things kind of look a little more touched up, a little kind of different feel to it. But then you see stuff like that, and I don't know, maybe not. That's a storage track there, I think. This place is massive. Flatlanding it a little bit. Got some kind of plant over there. What's this here? Alright, so that's the cellulose plant there. So what? And then that is knob mount. Crosses over right there. Dude, this is just, it's out of control. This is out of control. Rocket center. Not sure what that is. Maybe like natural gas or something? Possibly. Patterson Creek cutoff. Okay, this is where I thought we were earlier. Nope. Alright, there's a cellulose plant. We are getting close to knob mount. And then there's Cumberland off to the right. There's Ridgely. William Street. Those of you that have played Train Sim World will figure out this place pretty quick up here. Is Cumberland. Sand patch grade. Who knows? Maybe one day we'll get the rest of it. Split apart again. There's a cellulose plant there. Some more industry. Big old open face rock there. Alright, is this the knob mount yard? Alright, so we're almost to, I'm letting scenery load in as well, because there's a lot of stuff right here, as you can see. At this point, I'm going to go ahead and take a break, stretch my legs, grab me a snack, and then when I get back, we'll magically continue from this point on. Alright, continuing on. to what feels like the biggest train simulator map ever. Jeez, I forgot where the heck we were at. Alright, there's Ridgely. Let's see. Another old yard of some sort. Looks like maybe a turntable used to be there. Got a tunnel going through the mountain over there. Getting close to Cumberland. Alright, this, I believe, is the line. Yeah, so see this way, this is the sand patch grade, kind of goes north and then west. Let's see. Let's see how far up here we can go. Yeah, it dead ends right there. All right, so back down. So it's cool to see Cumberland in this era. Pretty good sized bridge right there. That is very nice. Another tower. So this is essentially where you will branch off and head to West Virginia, over that way. Just a dang good looking area. This church. So this looks to be an area that's got special attention, as it should. It's one of the anchors of the route itself, Cumberland. Huge. Pretty good sized town and definitely large with railroading. Still is to this day. Like an old bank or something. Got the fence line going across here. It's nice. Oh, hello. Nice. So the new piece of crap Amtrak station that is in modernity is right here. And it looks nothing like that. That is gorgeous. It's a shame stuff like that is not around to this day. And heading on into Cumberland Yard. Wait, is that where the Amtrak station was? Yeah. Yeah, I think so. The new one looks nothing like that back there. Alright, so if you're a Train Sim World 2 player, you'll figure this place out pretty quick. This has got a unique bridge that goes under the tracks. Tracks don't go over it. The road was dug under, which is pretty cool. So, Cumberland Yard, Cumberland offices, got the turntable over here. It's relatively the same. Obviously been changed and shrunk over the years. Different facilities. I mean, it's a big yard, but some of it just kind of looks very bland, if I'm honest. I believe this is where the car doctors are nowadays. Bad order shop there. There's the hump, none of which remain anymore to this day, sadly. Hump yards. All right, and down that away is our rolling stock. So we're going to start with the cars. I tried to put just about every single one down. There are loaded, empty variants, etc. So, tanker, 40 footers, different B&O liveries, brown, C&O, different C&O liveries. There's a Clinchfield, gray. Yeah, what's that supposed to be reading? The green ones. L&N, which is pretty cool. Monin, which is pretty cool. Ammunition Transport, that's an army car. More Chessie. I believe these are, yeah, these are the 50 footers to start here. Single and double doors. Clinchfield cushion car. Triple seat. Western Maryland and the waffle cars, which I don't know if these are new or not. I don't remember seeing these in the game before. Maybe they're not. And right here we got all our cabooshes. Got the bay winders, different B&O variants. The Chessie, red B&O, and the couple of cabooses. And we got the protection over the glass there. Then we got different variations of flat cars here, different loads. Got some TOFCs, and you know, they look pretty nice for what they are. Now, none of this stock is groundbreaking. A lot of this stuff is old, just rebranded. Again, with a lot of the North American roots that we've gotten as of late, I would say this one is a more in the quantity over quality category. So it's just inundated with a bunch of fairly old stuff. Sure, cold guns here. Just repainted, maybe touched up texture-wise. A lot of it's from other packs, like some of the retro packs from High Iron. Hanover Sub, a couple of different hoppers, some low side guns. There's your reefer. You get one reefer. So that's it right there. That is all the rolling stock that you get. And I think I didn't place down at least like five or six of them that were essentially the same. You know, it's basically looking at one thing in a different color. But, you know, it's, you get a lot. You know, I won't, well, yeah, you get a lot. It's quite a bit of stuff you get. And then over here, I've got the engines. Now, this is where the frames get kind of heavy. Some of the stuff scripted and made in such a way that it's not too friendly on frames. And so we're going to be checking these out. I tried to spread them out as much as possible just so your ears don't bleed having them side by side. But anywho, we'll go ahead and check these out now. All right, so first up, DTM equipment. These are essentially the SW1200, which was DNRGW Rio Grande when they initially came out. You got SW1200, SW7, SW9. They're essentially the same thing, just like the Hanover Sub Heritage packs, or Retro packs, sorry. They just are supposed to have different power outputs. It's, it's a DTM model. You know, there's not a lot to say. They've kind of looked the same over the past decade, I guess. One thing I will say is that they don't seem to have that incredible lustery shine to them. So I'll give them that. Go ahead and hop on this one here. Check out the heads. Still kind of, you know, not so good lighting. Give it a toot. Got that old single chime with a incredibly bad loop. same bell that's used with pretty much all the DTM stock. Of course, everything should open and close. The interior appears to be cleaned up a little bit in certain places. I may be completely mistaken here. The control stand is just way too dark. There's no contrast to it. You can't tell what's what. It just looks like a black hole in the middle of the universe. Yeah. The there's a couple of different liveries, I guess you could say. They're all B&O, I think. Yeah, they're all B&O. They're essentially the same. So we're going to just go ahead and scoot right on past and get on down to, I think, what a lot of people have been looking forward to is the SD35. Now, one of the glaring things I noticed when I was putting these suckers down for this in the editor is the plate, the bottom plate, something looks off. Really, really off. You see this slant here? They don't look like that from everything I've ever seen. They're pretty straight across. The back one looks okay. It's just something going on here. I don't know what it is. We'll go ahead and hop in this one. Then we'll give it a toot. Well, that's a GP30 horn off the same GP30 that he's made. It is an SD35. It's cool, I guess, to have a new model, if you will. The texturing's nothing really to write home about. Again, it's not very shiny, so it doesn't have that crazy alpha channel to it. Things like the fuel tank down there looks like it was painted with a brown airbrush and maybe like Microsoft Paint or something like that. And this may sound mean, and I know certain people in the community will be like, your expectations are too high. This is perfect. Well, this might have been perfect for like 2006, but it's 2021. I feel like you should always be improving, if anything. And I just feel like a lot of the stuff is just the same stuff over and over. But that's just me. I guess I'm entitled to my opinion. Anyway, we'll hop in the cab. Very clean, which I doubt these would have been. All that seems to work. Windows and doors should open. It is, after all, a DTM model. If you want nothing except opening doors and windows, DTM is for you. I feel like I'm good there. Here's a B&O chassis. Gorgeous Western Maryland. That livery. Oh. C&O. I like the C&O as well. Looks good. You see what I'm talking about? With the plate, the yellow plate down the side? Something is not right there. And in the circus, one could say, with the rolling stock on this pack, the circus is most definitely in town. And then you've got just an insane amount of GP9s. Long hood forwards, regulars. Apparently these were updated a little bit. We'll hop in this long hood forward here. The horn sounds pretty good. The horn is not too bad. The only problem with it is it's got a definitive loop to it that you can't alter. You just hit the key and it does its thing, and you gotta wait till it's done. Not only that, but I gotta press the key, the space bar, several times before it actually goes. But, yeah, they're older. GP9s, I think they were updated. Lights aren't anything great, but they're better than the DTM stock, that's for certain. Yeah, it's a GP9. Interior, apparently they touched up the texturing and paint and stuff like that in here, but it, I mean, to me, it just still looks like the same old GP9, if I'm honest. You know. Moving on! So you got a ton of them, you know, like I said, quality over quantity. You got like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 friggin' GP9 variants. And then last but not least, hopefully, the GP40. Which has some kind of weird looking chassis colors going on. Same old GP40 horn. It's got that quick blast. Headlights were never terrible. I'll give them that. Get in the cab, pretty much looks the same as the GP40-2s and the GP40-2 pack. So that's it. I mean, once again, I kind of went into this knowing that the rolling stock was gonna be pretty substandard. Well, that's not even true. I guess standard is what one could say. But like I said, you do get a lot of it. You get a ton of rolling stock. So I guess, you know, if you need yard filler and stuff like that, and you want a lot of these cars that are up here, these freight cars and different liveries and things like that, then it's perfect. But it's, you know, it's another one of those add-ons where it's the map, the route. That's, you know, that's what you're getting. That's what I see personally as, you know, whether up to you and how you feel, is if you think it's worth the money. Those things are way too friggin' loud, by the way. You know, to pick up the route, I personally think the route looks fantastic. It is massive. I feel I didn't do near, you know, a good enough job that someone could have done that's you know, lives and been in this area, that people like to do, that, you know, see something in train sim and, you know, they'll just pick it apart because they know everything about it. I guess you could say I kind of have the luxury of not doing that because I only know a little bit about the area, you know, just enough to get going. But it is a nice map. It's a very good looking map, and it's nice to have, you know, another Eastern Railroad that, you know, you can just have tons of fun with. I mean, the map is just massive. But there's, you know, there's all kinds of freeware out there if you're not interested in the stock that you can pick up that, you know, are more modern and up to date, better sounding, better looking, things of that nature. But I always like to do these as kind of like a first look or overview. But if I had to throw a number on it, you know, like all the recent stuff with North American rolling stock, I'd say, you know, maybe like a 6, 6.5 out of 10, just random number generator, just because it is, after all, train sim. So I'd say it's about high time we get some new models and some new sounds. I'm sure a lot of people disagree with me, and that's perfectly fine. But this is another route where, you know, if you're expecting something groundbreaking, rolling stock wise, the ground will very much remain intact. But I love the route. I think it's a good purchase. I can think of a lot of stuff I'm going to get started with running here. Namely, But anyway, this was a lengthy video, almost exhaustive. If you made it this far, and you did watch the whole thing and didn't skip to the end, thanks for watching. And that'll do it. I'll catch you next time. Take care.